This would be a very quick class where we'll try to understand about IAS CSET paper 2. What we will be doing is a comparative analysis of the papers for 2014 and 2015, and we'll see what are the changes and what are the areas we need to focus on. So here are some of the topics that we must and must know based on the previous year's papers. So you have questions from logical reasoning, usually asked based on statement argument, statement conclusion, and then you have numerous questions based on syllogism problem. You can refer to our specific video that covers syllogism. Then you have questions on non-verbal reasoning. Typically the questions are related to the problems on of cube and dice, like if three sides are painted or three sides have certain color number, what would be the number opposite to this number? So questions like that. Then you have number series, you have logical and advanced series questions. Then in name of reading comprehension, there are numerous questions that are asked, usually based on the passage. Now these passages are nowadays more and more contemporary related to general studies. So if you are very good with your editorial reading, then you can quickly solve the questions related to reading comprehension. Then you have questions related to issues which are related to environment and recent policy formulations or any program that have been launched. Questions from elementary maths are usually from the areas of speed time problems, train problems, board problems, ratio, proportion. Then you have pipes and cisterns, HCF, LCM, averages, mixtures. So these are some of the commonly asked questions. Now, rather than being a direct question, a numerical question based on elementary mathematics, the questions that are asked are usually in the form of word problems. So it's very important to understand and comprehend the word problem and apply our right logic. That means you should be able to understand whether this problem involves questions related to HCF or LCM and so on. Then you have some advanced concepts in mathematics like permutation combinations and mixtures. And finally, questions related to analytical reasoning, which says which of the A is taller than B, B is taller than C, who among the following is the tallest, and questions like those covered under analytical reasoning. So you have questions related to order, arrangement, problems of sitting arrangement. Then you have blood relation and direction questions that you need to focus on. Now, what is important for specifically for paper 2 is to analyze your weaknesses and your strengths. So say someone who is from a science background might feel that I am good at problems related to mathematics. However, I need focus on reading comprehension. Other person from social sciences background might say that he is good at portions related to reading comprehension, but needs a lot of practice in analytical and logical reasoning. So it's important that you analyze your own strengths and weaknesses and then move forward for practice. Now, what I have covered here is a comparative analysis of the number of questions asked. So you have the blue that shows 2014 and this is 2015. So as you can see, reading comprehension, you have nearly equal number of questions that are asked. Data interpretation, in 2014, there was a single question which was based on graph and you had two or three questions asked on that, and then you had a table and you had two or three questions asked on that. However, this pattern changed for 2015, and for 2015 there were individual questions on graph. That means you have one graph and one question related to that graph. You have second graph and you have second question related to graph. That means you have to apply more and more time. Since there are only 80 questions that are asked, some of the students might feel there is ample of time to attempt the paper, but no. Specifically in case where you have individual questions being asked, what is the benefit of having 5 questions with one graph? If you have solved or if you have calculated the total value or the average value once, you can apply those in the second question and third question and that would save your time. However, in case you have just one question on one graph, you will have to do that again for the second graph with different values. So it implies that you have to devote more time to solve these problems. Questions on basic maths definitely increase this time, and more questions were related to HCF, LCM, ratio and proportion. Logical reasoning, more or less the number of questions were same. Questions on ethical issues were asked, around 13 questions were there in 2015. 14 paper. However, there were just 3 questions in 2015. That means there is a lot of fluctuation. However, we cannot predict that for 2016 there would be less number of ethical questions or not. And then analytical reasoning were more or less the same. So what is important to note here is there were a lot of questions which implied ethical knowledge which were less this time. And then you have questions related to Venn diagram that drastically increased. So we'll be covering a dedicated session where we'll be talking about how to solve problems related to Venn diagram. Though they are simple problems, we'll really learn quick shortcuts to solve problems related to Venn diagrams. Then you had passages which were based on political science and recent policies and programs. That were 7 this time, 7 questions based on passages. And the most important thing to note here was nearly all questions were independent with independent passages. So you had, for example, a passage of 6 lines and then you had a single question based on that passage, another passage of 7 lines and then one question on that passage. That means you have to have a very good reading speed that can be developed only if you are thorough with your newspapers daily. You had numerous questions, around 3 questions this time on permutation combination, which were not at all asked in 2014. That means you need to know the basics of advanced maths. Then non-verbal reasoning, the number of questions decreased this time. Environmental issues, there were nearly more or less the same questions. There were one question on direction both the time, so definitely you should expect another question on direction this time. And there was in 2014 there was a question on clocks and calendars. Now from this we come to know these were the focus areas that were there for 2014. The focus area was ethical issues, concepts related to public administration, I could say basic ethics involved in administration. Those were the focus area for 2014. However, for 2015, the focus changed drastically and there were a lot of questions related to basic elementary maths and advanced maths, specifically permutation combination and Venn diagrams. We'll be covering those in separate sessions. And then finally, in 2015, there were passages which were based on recent happenings. This time again, I believe there would be lots and lots of passages which will be based on recent policy issues or recent changes, governmental changes that have been taken place. Now, what are the remarkable differences between the two papers, I would say? First is, as I mentioned before, 2015 involved lot of short passages and individual graph questions. So, it was a highly time consuming paper as compared to 2014. So all you need to do is you need to be very quick with your speed and practice a lot. And finally, there was increase in the difficulty level, specifically in the mathematics section, because there were questions asked on permutation and combination, and there were decrease in the number of questions asked on non-verbal reasoning. But that, however, does not imply that again this year there would be further decrease in non-verbal reasoning. You need to be very sure that questions related to non-verbal reasoning can fluctuate off and on. Now, here is something you must focus on. First is, you must read the editorials of The Hindu thoroughly. Specifically, ideas related to polity, governance, environmental issues. So these were the focus areas. You can read other articles related to economics as well. That works too good. But what were asked till now were mainly based on polity, governance and environmental issues. Then you must increase your vocabulary. Since for reading comprehension, there is no Hindi version that is there. You must be very fluent with your English. You should have good idea about logical and critical thinking. So problems related to arrangement, Venn diagram, logical and analytical reasoning should be on your tips. And finally, you should leave no stones unturned. However, there are less questions that are being asked related to algebra, trigonometry and geometry, but you should not leave those areas untouched, because there can be probability that this time there are questions related to geometry or trigonometry similar to what they were for permutation and combination last year. Now here are some of the questions that are essentially there every time. So 1 and 2 questions definitely on speed and time problems, race, pipes, work, HCF, LCM, profit loss, number series. 1 and 2 questions definitely from these sections. 1 and 2 definitely from directions and blood relations. 1 and 2 from clocks and calendars. So these are some of the questions that are fixed. So if you are thorough with these topics, you are sure to secure that much marks. And these questions are dedicatedly word problems again. Here are some of the good links that you can refer to practice these topics well. And finally, wish you a good luck for your exam. We'll be covering Venn diagram in the next session. You can subscribe to our channel for any further updates. Have a good day ahead.